Not to be too politically correct, but it's kind of apples and oranges. You know, sometimes playing in a venue when it's your audience, there's something cool about that because you're in total control of that night. You're in total control of that show. You know, if you want to play an extra couple songs, you can do it. If the crowd's really feeling it and you're really into it, you can kind of take control, and there's more autonomy and freedom in a show like that. Whereas in a festival, you've got to adhere to these really strict set times, and it's more rudimentary at times. But then at the same time, you know, we get to share the bill with some pretty amazing people today, and that's like not only an honor, but it's inspiring and it's exciting for us. You know, something it's cool to be able to say we played with these kind of brothers.
Someday I'll be coming home. Cast iron soul.
So I dropped out of school when I was 21 years old, and that was when MySpace was this new thing. Like, everyone's like, have you heard of MySpace? It's social media. Like, what is social media?
Digital buzz.
Get on here, you click add friend like 500 times a day, and you can get fans online. That's what social media was at that point for me. And it was interesting in that, you know, for the first time, it put real power in independent musicians' hands. I had nobody, you know, no manager, no publicist, no booking agent, no label, obviously. And it was like, I still had, if I had the initiative, I could get on and go seek out fans online. And that was a totally new frontier for musicians. So that was an exciting time. But then, like everything, MySpace was the first to rise and fall, followed by a myriad of other social media sites.
Right.
More will follow after that. But yeah, it taught me a valuable lesson because I put all my stock in that. I thought, you know, I was a little bit more naive, a little bit younger at that point. I was like, this will be around forever. This is so cool.
Right.
Just keep doing this and grow this huge audience.
I can't see the water. I can't taste the sea. Keep on moving farther from where I need to be. To California.
What's another milestone you would like to hit, I guess? Because a lot of artists would love to say that the name's been enrolled in town.
You know, we got to play Conan O'Brien, which he was my favorite late night guy. I loved Conan. Like, he's on cable now,
right?
So I don't have cable TV, but we got to play his show, which was great. That was like a real bucket list thing for me.
Yeah.
Like, I know his skits and stuff.
I'm looking forward to seeing you guys' stuff this afternoon. Did I hear you say your wife is expecting?
Yeah, July 20th. I will be
young.
Daddy,
good Lord willing.
Congratulations.
Babysitter right here. Uncle's at.